Hi, my name is Germán Abrevaya, and today I'm going to talk about a Julia implementation of generative latent differential equation models. This project is done in collaboration with all these amazing people around the world for whom I'm truly grateful. And this work can be understood in the context of scientific machine learning, an exciting emerging field which tries to combine traditional mechanistic modeling, usually based on dynamical systems, with a much younger but yet powerful field of machine learning, and in doing so, enrich them both. For example, bringing interpretability to machine learning, more sensible dimensionality reduction, and better predictions. In the past few years, Julia has proven that it is undoubtedly the best language to work in this bridging field, and now most of the contributions in this direction have converged into the SciML ecosystem. One of the best examples of scientific machine learning is the case of the universal differential equations, which you have probably heard about because they were developed by the great Chris Rakakas and other great people from the Julia community. Let's see its basic idea with the popular Locke-Tabulteri equations, which model predator-prey dynamics. Suppose that you have this data, but for some reason you cannot build a full mechanistic model. However, you can do some educated guesses on some part of a model. The proposal of the universal differential equation is to use universal approximators, such as artificial neural networks, to learn the unknown parts. Then you could even use a sparse regression to get symbolic expressions out of your trained neural networks. This is an example of how you can make use of prior knowledge about your system and fill the gaps with machine learning. This is a really powerful tool, and I strongly suggest you check out their paper and the defect flags package. However, this approach, as any other approach, has its own limitations, such as the need to have direct observations of the state variables of your model. What if you have some high-dimensional data for which you can guess that the underlying dynamics are actually happening in a much lower-dimensional manifold? Such as the case of this pendulum video, where you have as many dimensions as pixels in each frame, but the dynamics are actually ruled by the simple pendulum equations. Well, one possible approach to tackle this problem could be the generative latent differential equation models that are implemented in our package. You could think of these models as some kind of variational encoders with differential equations inside. Let's see a general structure shared by various models of this kind. You start with a high-dimensional time series, and the goal is to reconstruct it by passing through a much lower dimensional latent space, in which the dynamics are ruled by some differential equations. First, each frame is passed independently through a feature extractor, usually reducing the dimensionality. Then, it is sequentially processed by a recurrent pattern extractor in order to learn the distributions of the initial conditions, or initial conditions and parameters, of a differential equation which will be next integrated. Finally, the generated trajectory go through a last transformation to go back to original space. It is worth noting that in all of these models, you can also integrate the differential equation further in order not only to reconstruct the input, but also to make predictions on the future evolution of the system. One of the models that you can find implemented in our package is the latent ODE model, which simplest version was proposed in the now famous neural ODEs paper. In this case, you have some fully connected layers as feature extractor, then some RNNs, which learn the mean and variance of the initial conditions for the differential equation. Here, you don't propose a particular form for the differential equation, but use another neural network to parameterize it. And lastly, you have another fully connected layer. So in this case, a neural network is used to learn the differential equation. But what if you have a guess on what the specific overlapping equations are? Well, in such case, you could use this other model that it is also implemented in our package, the generative ODE modeling with known unknowns, also called GokuNets. In this case, you have some ResNets for feature extraction, then some RNNs, as we had in the previous case, for learning the initial conditions, but this time we also have some bidirectional STMs for learning the parameters of the differential equations, which in this case are explicitly provided. And then finally, another ResNet for going back to the original space. So in the pendulum example, we will have the pendulum videos as input, all of these dimensions correspond to all the pixels in each frame, then the pendulum equations would go inside here with the length as the parameter. And finally, after being trained, we would be able to reconstruct the input and predict further in the future, passing through the latent phase space. Let's see a particular result. In this case, we have trained the model with sequences of 80 frames, but afterwards, we fed the model with only 15 frames from a sample which was unseen during training. In this video, I am showing 100 frames just for reference. Then I can let the integration go beyond the reconstruction time, which is marked with this red dashed line, in order to predict the time evolution of the system after the reconstruction time. Here, for simplicity, I plot only the first state variable, sit1, which will represent the angle. The left axis corresponds to the inferred sit1 in blue, and the right axis to the ground truth in green. You can notice that even though the reconstructed and predicted frames are quite good, the inferred phase space doesn't match. In this case, the predicted ground truth angles have a phase shift and different scales. This is a manifestation of an identifiability issue, mainly due to the high expressivity of the layers coming before and after the differential equations, which was already reported in the original GoGoNet paper, and it is definitely worth more discussion and research. However, even if you don't recover the same latent dynamics that generated your data, finding this compatible latent representation can be useful for dimensionality reduction, forecast, and also for characterizing your system. Now, going back to the more general case, in latenteffect.jl, it is straightforward to change each component layer, allowing for easy exploration of different and possible better architectures. The models implemented in our package can be a useful complement to defect flags for dealing with problems of higher dimensionality than the phase space of your differential equation models. We have implemented latent ODEs and GoGoNet models, and just by having them implemented in Julia, endless possibilities are enabled thanks to the power of the SciML ecosystem and flags. For example, out of the box, it is already possible to use stochastic differential equations, which wasn't available in the original implementation, or use universal differential equations and choose between many alternative solvers and adjoint methods. You can find our package along with some examples and tutorials in this link, and it is worth noting that this is a work in progress and any contributions and suggestions are very welcome. Thank you so much for listening.